Hello guys, it is Leszek from Retro Cooking Channel and today I'm going to cook Bigos. It is a very traditional, very popular Polish dish. It is made from sauerkraut. So if you like sauerkraut, it is probably what you want to try. It's very delicious and easy to make. So first, what you need Polish smoked sausage, kiełbasa. You can buy this in Polish shop or in hypermarket. Could be German smoked sausage, but tastes a little bit different. Half small onion. By the way, I'm using Pressure King Pro 3 liters. So if you using 5 liters or any other pressure cooker, it doesn't matter because I have 3 different and cook almost exactly the same. So you can double this measurement. So first we need sauté the bacon and onion and sausage. Not too much, but we need this nice flavor. You can use Polish bacon, but just standard bacon from and the shop is good. Vegetable oil, and we need sauté this. In meantime, we need to prepare sauerkraut. Again, you can buy this in Polish shop or in hypermarket. Choose Polish one. German is a little bit different, but it's still okay. And we need to wash this, because if you put just from the jar, will be too sour. Bigos is recipe for Bigos is probably the same like recipe in stew in Britain. That means each house has own recipe, so you can find a recipe that you're using half fresh cabbage and half sauerkraut. But in my home, my mom was using just sauerkraut, and we was preparing sauerkraut at home. Yes, I remember that we spent whole day just for making sauerkraut, and after about 3 weeks was ready, was so delicious. And so now what I did, I add a little bit water because I wanted all this flavor from the bottom of the pan was going to the sauce, to the Bigos. And now we need add some meat. I'm using ribs, but chicken or any meat is good actually. The ribs is the best, but it's up to you. One bay leaf, one teaspoon of black peppercorns, one chicken cube. If you're using chicken cube, if you're using stock from chicken cube, you don't need add too much salt because it's salt already. One tablespoon of tomato puree, concentrated tomato puree, and about 200 milliliters of water, 200-250 milliliters of water. It's actually, that's it. Just add a little bit marjoram, about 1 teaspoon. Marjoram is very important because one thing is adding extra flavor, and another thing make this dish more healthy, more easy for it. Set for stew soup for 50 minutes, and yeah, that's it. After this time, the dish is ready. Oh, it's so delicious. I eaten this hundreds of time, very like it, and hope that you will enjoy. So thank you very much for watching. If you like this video, please consider subscribing, because I'm adding new videos almost every day, at least twice a week. And if you have any suggestions for future videos, just leave me the comment. If you like something or you don't like, please leave me a comment as well, because it's helping me a lot. So thanks a lot and enjoy. Bye!